So today you are going to help us know more about the west end of Toronto. So the first question pop up in my mind on the topic of real estate. Mm-hmm. What's the biggest difference between west end and east end of Toronto? Besides the housing price.
Yeah, well, now remember, Toronto is a huge city.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have many, many communities within the city. Mm-hmm. So I'm obviously from the West End, so I'm very partial mm-hmm. to the West End. Some of the things that I like specifically is one, access to the airport. The airport happens to be in the West End.
That's right.
So you have great transportation, very great accessibility to the international airport. The neighborhoods that I live in are very close to the downtown core. Mm-hmm. So that means you've got great shopping and you've got great amenities and great restaurants and sporting activities and theater. I also like the West End, particularly because of the accessibility to the lake. Mm-hmm. Toronto has, of course, this big lake on the water. It's right on the water there. And so we have these communities that are very accessible to the water.
你而家收睇嘅系加拿大财经一号电视台。
家国地产发展趋势，近期楼市最新动态。地产行业权威发布，众多专家分析点评，尽在置业家国。
Hello everyone, welcome to today's Wonder TO. When we talk about the real estate market of Toronto, we always see it as a whole.But when we look into the market, different neighborhoods has different market features and market potential. So today we have guests in the studio to talk about the east and west end of the city. Hello, Marnie.
Hi.
Hi, welcome to our show.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
We want to know more about you. So why don't you give us a brief introduction about yourself and what your specialty is?
Sure, I will. Absolutely. My name is Monty Burris, and I'm the founder and the owner of the Trust Realty Group here in Toronto. Mm-hmm. We're a team of realtors who are neighborhood specialists. We specialize and sell specifically in the neighborhoods that we live in. Mm-hmm. And for me, that's the West End of Toronto. Mm-hmm.
So today you are going to help us know more about the west end of Toronto. So the first question pop up in my mind on the topic of real estate. Mm-hmm. What's the biggest difference between west end and east end of Toronto? Besides the housing price.
Yeah, well, now remember, Toronto is a huge city.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have many, many communities within the city. Mm-hmm. So I'm obviously from the West End, so I'm very partial mm-hmm. to the West End. Some of the things that I like specifically is one, access to the airport. The airport happens to be in the West End.
That's right.
So you have great transportation, very great accessibility to the international airport. The neighborhoods that I live in are very close to the downtown core. Mm-hmm. So that means you've got great shopping and you've got great amenities and great restaurants and sporting activities and theater. I also like the West End, particularly because of the accessibility to the lake. Mm-hmm. Toronto has, of course, this big lake on the water. It's right on the water there. And so we have these communities that are very accessible to the water, which
very
is
very good to know. When people say West End of Toronto, the first two areas pop up in my mind is Parkdale and Queen West.
Yeah.
But I don't have a really clear drawing about which area, like where it starts and where does it end. So
okay,
can you help us on this point?
Absolutely. Technically, I think is anything west of Yonge Street would be considered the West mm-hmm. End. But what you have is basically a finance community, stuck in between. So really you don't start getting into residential communities till about Spadina or Bathurst even.
Mm-hmm.
So really what we're talking about is west of Bathurst running right to the Humber River. And the Humber River is the border between Toronto and Etobicoke, mm-hmm. which is one of the suburbs of Toronto, of course.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a particularly big area. It is filled with about 700,000 people. Okay, 690,000 people. But it's very, very dense, a lot of people and a lot of very distinct communities.
According to what you said, this area is like huge, right? We can't talk about the whole thing like in one episode, but you're going to introduce three communities particularly
Absolutely.
Today, right?
Absolutely. So I talked a little bit about Parkdale. So I'm going to move a little bit further west to an area called High Park Roncesvalles. Mm. And actually, that's the neighborhood that I live in, so I know it best. Mm. High Park Roncesvalles is right adjacent to the largest park in the whole city. It's called High Park. Mm-hmm. And it runs all the way down to the waterfront and all the way north to Bloor Street. Mm-hmm. Okay? So this is the area just on the little bit, a little bit to the east side of the park and runs to Lansdowne Street. It's essentially a strip that runs all the way up to Bloor. It's filled with about 5,000 houses, okay? What you have here is a very educated community, so people that are professionals, working professionals, likely they either work out of their homes or they work in the downtown core and they like the accessibility to the downtown. Mm-hmm. They're also, by and large, family-oriented. Mm-hmm. It's the highest density of residents with families and young kids in the whole city, okay? And I think that's why they go near to the park. Mm. And it's a great community. Another neighborhood that I'm going to talk to you about is just a little bit north of that, and that's called The Junction. Mm-hmm. And The Junction is called that because it used to be the terminus of two railway stations. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it was the junction where people got off of the railway. This is a much smaller community, and it's very up and coming. It's less expensive, and it's a much younger community. Mm. So these would be young professionals, I guess, starting off. Mm-hmm. And then finally, the third area I would talk about is a little bit further west, and it's called Bloor West Village. Mm-hmm. Which is a very old neighborhood. It's right on the subway line of Bloor, and it stretches from Bloor Street north to Dundas, mm-hmm. and it has to be west of Jane Street.
Mm, wow, you very know your areas.
Yes, I do.
Well, besides location, I think education is another very important factors for people to like choose housing. So how do you, like, what kind of education reputations yeah. around these three
Excellent.
Communities.
They're all really, really, really well, mm-hmm. really well known for their education. And they're all family neighborhoods by and large. So education is a very important factor into them. In the High Park neighborhood, I'll pick one school to talk about in specific. It's called Garden Avenue Public School. Mm-hmm. And it is the second smallest school in the whole city. It's tiny. Oh. And it only-
It's public?
It is public. It's a public school. And it runs from junior kindergarten to grade six. And it only has 140 students in it. So it's almost like a private school because it's so small. It has a huge amount of parental involvement in it. And it has a very, very high standards. Mm-hmm. In Bloor West Village, there is a very, very, one of the best high schools in the whole city called Ursula Franklin Academy. In fact, it's ranked the third best high school in all of Toronto. It's also a public school. Mm-hmm. And it's really, really well known for its mathematics department. And that's in Bloor West Village. Excellent reputation and excellent parental involvement to that one. There are also many private schools mm-hmm. nearby that a lot of people opt for.
Now we have gathered all of the information about the environment or the education and demographic, and now we're going to get into the market. How is the market doing?
Really well, actually. Mm-hmm. You know, the Toronto housing market has been on an incredible run for about 16 years.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's been 16 years of almost straight line growth. And that is up until maybe about 2 months ago, and there was some legislation that was brought in by the provincial government, which slightly slowed things down. Mm-hmm. And you know what? That's a good thing. Because the numbers were getting too crazy.
That's right.
Okay, so now what we're talking about is more moderate growth. So we're talking about 6% to 8% growth, which is more sustainable for a longer period of time. Now, who wouldn't want 8% growth on their investment? That's really, really nice, and there's less risk involved than those big double-digit numbers. So it's doing very well.
Or so according to numbers, even though well, a lot of popular areas like Richmond Hill or Markham, those for the past 2 months, the number has dropped dramatically. But
yes.
Toronto has stayed popular, like
that's
stay.
Right.
Also, the price has been going up.
Yes.
So that's the. What do you think? Why is that?
Okay, there's a number of factors I think that go into it. The neighborhoods that I'm talking about are so small and so unique. Mm-hmm. So let me just give you an idea, okay? The largest one of those is Bloor West Village, but Bloor West Village only had 180 sales all of 2016. Mm-hmm. So it's a very desirable neighborhood to get into. It's very competitive to get into that. The Junction I talked about only had 108 sales. So it's very competitive to get in there. And when you have these neighborhoods that are small and very, very desirable, of course, the downturns aren't going to be as severe, mm-hmm. okay, because they still have their appeal. And there's just very few options. Whereas Richmond Hill and Markham and mainly the suburbs are much larger, much bigger neighborhoods. And so when things swing one way, and then they swing the other way, it's a much more dramatic turn.
Mm-hmm. Well, this week we read some of the news that the condo market has been going up.
Yes.
And then do you have any suggestions for like condo project around West End of
Toronto? Yeah, there's not many of them, to be honest with you. And thus, they've been going up dramatically, as you can imagine. I'll give you a story. I'm just about to put one on the market mm-hmm. for clients of mine who bought 5 years ago. They bought it for $500,000, and I'm about to market it for $1,050,000 in 5 years. So it's wow. doubled in the last 5 years. There just isn't condo alternatives, very many options in the West End of the city, mm-hmm. At least the neighborhoods that I spoke of. So they're there, but they're very highly sought afters. They sell out like that, and you really have to make sure that you're talking to people who are in the know.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, Marty.
No problem.
We really enjoyed the conversation. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. 家国地产发展趋势，近期楼市最新动态。地产行业权威发布，众多专家分析点评，尽在置业家国。